Hey, see that big blimp? What's the Brotherhood of Steel? Why are they here?
Heard you rescued Valentine.
What work?
All sense scared the hell out of me, Dicky.
Yeah, it's true. I got shot in the ass last year. Let's do it.
Got a minute? Drinks on me.
I've always got a minute for a free drink.
Well, pull up a chair then.
What do you want?
I'm in town looking for Henry Cook. Do you know where I might find him?
Well, why are you looking for him?
Fair question. He's my father. I haven't heard from him in a while, so I came to town to check up on him.
I haven't seen him.
If you say so, I'll probably see you around town. Bye.
Hey.
When I want to talk to you, I'll let you know.
Ah, yes, you. Famous Bobra of liquor, on tap all day.
Earl Sterling used to work here, right?
Poor Earl. Gone just like that. Such a good bartender. Good friend. Oh, terrible with women, mind you. Bull in China shop with them. You with Valentine's Detective Agency? I forgot to drop off Earl's key when I hired you people. Here, I hope you find out what happened. Security does nothing but yell at me for asking about it. I got a bar to run. Let me know if you want something.
I'll think about it.
All right.
I'm not looking for a conversation right now.
All you outsiders wear such funny clothes?
No funny business. If you're hungry, you can grab a quick bite of power noodles. Just talk to the robot.
Okay. I ain't saying I want to shoot you, because that would be rude. But would you even feel it?
Hey, you were the one that walked that freedom trail, right?
That's good. Go, freedom.
Hey, Doc.
This better be an emergency.
Do you know anything about this receipt?
Let me see. This is Dr. Crocker's deplorable handwriting, all right. Looks like Earl Sterling was one of his patients. The procedure noted here is mundane, low-risk cosmetic work. Dr. Crocker never performed it, however. Said Earl vanished before he paid. Anyway, we should get back to your immediate medical requirements.
Where is Doc Crocker?
Last time I saw him, he had to get something out of the surgery cellar. Probably just had to wash some needles or move some storage around. Now, I must insist we talk about your medical needs.
I need to get into the cellar, Doctor.
What does this look like? A public outhouse? You know what? Don't answer. Why on earth would I let you down there?
I'm investigating a missing person, Doctor. And I think the trail leads to your basement.
A missing person? You're talking about Earl, aren't you? You can't honestly think... You know what? Fine. If it'll put the matter to rest, here, go see for yourself. But if I find one instrument out of place, you'll be getting the bill.
You there. We need to talk.
Is there a problem?
The problem is that I've learned that you killed my son Nelson. Is this true?
I didn't kill Nelson. Whoever told you that was lying.
You are an easy target for anyone trying to shift blame off themselves. If it wasn't you, then who was it? Do you know who killed Nelson?
I want to know who told you it was me.
I heard it from Morosky. Low-life Kim Pusher from Good Neighbor. Maybe he has some reason to bring trouble down on you. So, do you know anything about who killed Nelson?
I have no idea.
All right. I'll take your word for it. For now. But if I hear that you were the one lying to me...
Hey! goes right into the basement.
Oh, Earl. You've really been a handful, you know. But I think we're just about done. Our little mistake is finally going to be corrected. Oh, naughty, naughty. You're not supposed to be down here, but that's okay. I can fix that. I can fix anything.
What did you do to Earl Sterling, Doctor?
What did I do? I didn't do anything. It was Earl. It was Earl who didn't want to be happy. Good patients get a nice, new face. Bad patients bleed all over the floor because they want to screw up their surgeon's life!
You made a mistake. But you can still do the right thing, Doctor. Just think this through.
You're right. There's one thing I can do. Only one thing is going to make this all better. Can fix anything.
What's going on here? Is that Dr. Crocker? I think you owe me an explanation. What happened here?
Doc Crocker killed Earl Sterling. I found out, and then he killed himself. Guess he couldn't handle the guilt.
Dr. Crocker killed Earl? The facial reconstruction? So he really did go through with it? That explains a lot more than I'm comfortable with. Dr. Crocker always cared about his reputation, but this is inhuman.
You didn't know. It's not your fault.
Of course it's not my fault. That moron and his damn appearance over practice mentality. Now two lives have been lost. It's disgraceful. I better report all this to security. Get out of here. It's going to take a long time to clean this place of biohazards.
I suggest we take as much as we can carry.
Looks like it'll be a closed casket funeral.
Advanced CPUs, streamlined power systems. I often wish their hardware was compatible with my own.
Perkins.
I'm glad you're here. We got a new case while you and Nick were out. Ready to put on the detective hat?
Who's our client?
A fisherman, whose family lives on the edge of the Commonwealth. Kenji Nakano. Mr. Nakano didn't leave many details. Said he'd go over everything when you meet him. But if you want my guess, missing person case. Guy had a worried look a mile long.
Anything you can tell me about Kenji Nakano?
Just some impressions. He was obviously upset, but he was also in a hurry. Like, he couldn't stand just waiting around. I'm a friend of Nick's. He'll remember me. I need his help right away. And then he was gone. He was muttering something on the way out, but no. I'm not sure it was important.
Come on, Ellie. Don't hold out on me. What did he say?
Well, I thought I heard him say something about a daughter and also a radio, but I might have misheard him. Not sure how the two would be connected.
I'll go check it out. Thanks, Ellie.
The Nakano residence is up in the northeast, near the coast. A small fishing house. He said that he and his wife will be waiting for you.
Ellie?
So, you find out where Earl Sterling ran off to?
Earl never went anywhere. Doc Crocker killed him during a botched surgery.
Crocker killed Earl? Gone as long as he was, I figured maybe Raiders or the Institute, but Crocker? Where's the doc now? Rotting in a cell, I hope.
Crocker killed himself. He couldn't take the guilt.
Goodness. I'm sorry you had to go through that. Here, take this. Sounds like you earned it. I'll send word along. Let everyone down at the dugout inn know what happened. Shame it couldn't be better news. Thanks again for closing this one out.
Pam wants to talk with you. She's in back.
Without the help of some...
Hey, Tom.
Another Mila placed and even more. Got a lead on another vantage spot. If you got the time. But if you're here to check out the latest and greatest, that's good.
That's prohibitively dangerous.
Fixer, how do you feel about getting thrown back into the fire?
Is it that bad?
Potentially catastrophic. We've hit a snag with Dr. Amari. You haven't met her. She works in Good Neighbor and she plays a vital role in our organization. Synths are supposed to go to the memory den. The doctor gives them a new set of memories, then they move out. But her latest patient is stuck there. The runner's route has been compromised, and we're looking for options.
Why do synths get new memories?
The mind job is voluntary. Each synth has his or her own reasons for opting in. Most do it to avoid being captured. A synth knows nothing about our world. There's dozens of ways they could slip up and draw attention to themselves. Pam, what if we reroute through Lexington?
The switchboard is a nexus of Institute activity. Odds of detection increase exponentially with proximity to the Nexus.
In English, Pam.
She means we can't run ops anywhere remotely near Switchboard. The Gen 1's blocking the original route have to go.
I think the doctor's right.
You see? Even he agrees with me.
Enough. We do it your way, then. Go to Dr. Amari and tell her rerouting isn't possible. You're there to clear the route for one last run. There's a lot at stake here, so get the job done.
data set.
I suppose you're here for my medical services. Let's see what's wrong with you today.
Not now.
Let me know if that changes.
Pam.
Analyzing.
I'll cover you, sir. That was amusingly simple.
Time to die!
There's been panic about the new thing floating in the sky.
I thought it was one of Tinker Tom's aliens.
Aliens are real!
Enough! The blimp is called the Pridwin, and it's operated by the Brotherhood of Steel. The Brotherhood of Steel are a formidable, highly advanced order. And they've come here to destroy Synths.
Shit!
Spread the word. The Brotherhood are our enemies. There's no possibility of peace. Tinker Tom will be spearheading a fail-safe plan to deal with this Brotherhood. Codename Red Glare. But for now, we monitor them and keep them clear of our operations. The focus remains on the Institute. You've all got jobs to do. Do them.
Make sure you never followed here.
She'll have
it's all our asses if you are.
You gotta be careful, man. The Institute is everywhere. With that latest one, Mila's got good coverage of the Commonwealth. Could always use more Mila's placed.
If you're interested.
But if you're here to check out the latest and greatest, that's good.
I gotta go.
Right you are.
Hey.
Yes. You might want to drop some of those things you're carrying.
Still ain't perfect, but we're surviving.
Thank you.